I want to go over quickly with you how to manipulate a motion tween in Flash. So before we do that, let's go ahead and review how to create a motion tween. Right now I have a star on the stage and I have a layer named star. And I'm going to click on that object and do insert motion tween. It's going to tell me it needs to be a symbol, so you could have converted it to a symbol first. I'll click OK, and if I go to library, there's my symbol, and I might want to rename that, so I can right click and choose rename and call this MC star. So it's a good idea to get in the habit of just making it a symbol first so that you can give it a good name and then creating a motion tween. So it automatically gave me 24 frames because my frame rate is 24 frames per second, and it assumes that I want my animation to last at least a second. When I'm looking at this timeline, it's blue, that's telling you that there's a motion tween, and I see a black dot on frame one. That is a keyframe. That's telling you that there's some new content or a change in action. And truly, we do have it because all of a sudden, even though it's frame one, a star appears. There's no other black dot or black diamond on this motion tween, and that's because it doesn't change for all 24 frames. If I want it to change, I have to move my playhead to the place that I want it to, or the time that I want it to change to, and then make the change. So I'll move my playhead to frame 24 and move my star down to the bottom center of the screen. So now I've created two keyframes, and you can see with the little black diamond that that's your second keyframe. And it's going to create a motion path from point A to point B. So as I scrub my playhead along, there's our motion path. So let's talk about the first way that we can manipulate this path. We can hover our mouse over the motion path, and it's going to get a little arc symbol in the lower right hand corner of the cursor. And now I can click and drag, and I can create extreme arcs or just kind of a subtle arc for my motion path. And that's going to help it to curve. Now what happens if I want to add another second to my timeline? Well, right now I could stretch it out, and that's just going to show that's stretching the rate at which it moves from point A to point B. So it lasts longer and it's a lot smoother animation, but I actually wanted it to last longer so that after the 24th frame I could have the star come back up here. So let's undo that. And instead, I'm going to go out to the 45th frame and go to Insert Timeline Frame. That's just going to add more time to my motion tween. It didn't create a keyframe, so it took whatever the last state our star was in, and it just made it last to the 45th frame. Now I can move my playhead to the 45th frame, and I can move my star up here, and now you can see another motion path. So here we have it coming down and going back up, and that's the motion path that I wanted to create. Now I got this arc because I originally created an arc here so that it pulled and pushed on this motion path, and we're going to just leave it that way. So right now it's lasting about 2 seconds, actually it's approximately 1.8 seconds. So if I want it to last for 2 seconds, I'll go ahead and make this normal size. And with a motion tween, if you click inside of it once, you're going to select just one frame. If I select or click two times, it's going to highlight the entire motion tween. And now I can hover along the right edge or the left edge of that motion tween, and I can stretch it out or shorten it. So let's say I want to stretch this out to about 55, and now it's 2.3, so there we go, 50 seconds, 50 frames, now we have 2 seconds of animation. So that's where I want it to be. If I wanted it to be a lot longer, I could stretch it that way. And if I wanted it to be a lot shorter, I could stretch it this way. Now watch what happens when I shorten it. Right now, that center keyframe is about on frame 26. So if I shorten it, all of a sudden that center keyframe is around frame 13. So that might cause a problem for you when it moves those keyframes for you. In this instance, it was such a drastic change that it didn't matter to us. But if I'm out to 50 and I want maybe this to be on frame 24, then that causes a problem for me. No need to fear, I can actually move those individual keyframes myself. First thing I need to do is click off of that motion tween, then click once on the keyframe I want to move, and it'll isolate or select that one particular keyframe, which I can then move. So to show you an extreme example, if I put it on frame 40, then it's going to take a long time to get from 1 to the 40th frame, and then from 40 to 50, it goes really fast. So that's one way that you can manipulate and work with time by moving your keyframes around in your motion tween. Last thing I want to talk about in terms of moving things around is you can actually move the whole tween. So let's say I don't want to have the star start on frame 1. Let's say I want to have it come in on frame 30. I can double click that entire motion tween and then click and drag so that it moves that entire motion tween over. And then prior to that motion tween, we have a bunch of blank frames, and that's okay because at that point on the star layer, we don't have any content and it just shows up on the 30th frame. Last but not least, let's say I want to have a bunch of stars bouncing in and I want them to randomly happen at different times. Well, I like the animation setup that I have here, how long it lasts, where my keyframes are at. I just want to stagger and have a couple of stars come in. So I can do that by duplicating this actual tween. First, I can duplicate the layer by dragging it down and hovering over the new icon. And it doesn't look like anything's happening, but when you let go, it'll create a star copy. And it's in the exact same place. So I'll lock the first one. And for this one, I can go ahead and move it. Say I want it to be up here. And I'll copy it one more time. And for this one, let's say I want it to, you have to click on the motion path so that you can move the whole thing. So let's say I want it to happen there. And for each of these tweens, let's say I want this one to start on frame 12, and this one I want it to start a little bit later. So now we can see what's happening. We've got one that bounces in, and we're creating some kind of staggered animation. It's not the coolest thing, but hopefully you get the point with that. So you can definitely manipulate your motion tween, and you just have to get used to the way that you need to select things and making sure that what you want to move is what you've selected. So if you want to move the entire tween, don't just click here because you're going to end up dragging all kinds of stuff and then you've created these gaps and you don't want to do that. I have a tutorial video on YouTube about understanding the timeline, and that goes into greater depth into what things look like and how the timeline behaves. That will help you understand this a little bit more.